We're much more stable now. As you know, we had our December conference in Paris with the International Support Group, and the conference was a great success with President Macron. And we'll have a conference in Rome as well, Rome 2, which will target how the international community will help the Lebanese army and the security services. And then there will be the next Paris conference, the CEDAR conference, which President Macron will preside over as well. This conference will focus on the entire infrastructure of Lebanon. It's going to help the private sector come to Lebanon to invest in the country. And that will bring a lot of benefits for French society. In this conference, there are projects for electricity, roads, water, all that sort of thing. And we're going to focus also on aid from the international community, like the World Bank, the European Central Bank and such, and certain projects which wouldn't be feasible for businesses to invest in. As you know, in Lebanon, we have 1.5 million refugees, which is a lot to handle. We need economic growth. That's the only way we can really be able to take in those 1.5 million refugees. It's a burden Lebanon can't keep carrying. The idea of a political solution in Syria, I don't see it happening soon. So Lebanon is doing a public service for the entire world by allowing those 1.5 million refugees into our country. And I think the international community has a responsibility to Lebanon, as well as to Jordan. France has always played a unifying role.
Je crois que président Macron a une manière, une charisma qui.
I think President Macron has a way, a charisma, that is very effective at introducing dialogue in these countries.
Ce dialogue dans les pays qui ont un conflit.
I think France should play a role, and can play a role, because without this dialogue, where do we go?
On va où?
We have a very good relationship. Since I got back, we've had several meetings, secret up to this point. The relationship is excellent, and you'll see in the months to come how Saudi Arabia is going to engage more and more in Lebanon and in the region. The entire world is saying that we don't accept this decision. If the Americans want to do that, okay, they can do that. But it doesn't mean that Jerusalem is the capital of Israel. The important thing is that the whole world, with America, puts pressure on Israel to come back to the bargaining table to end the conflict between them and the Palestinians. Israel needs to understand that this conflict can't continue without end.